Omega. Let some people start to pile in. Let's see. I think it's being stretched. Let's see how it looks. 4x3. Yeah, it looks better. I like how I'm always a lot quieter when I stream than when I'm, like, recording. For those of you who are not in yet, this will be going up on YouTube. I guess I don't know why I'm reassuring you, because if you're not in yet, you won't be watching this until it's already on YouTube. Sonic Mega Collection Plus.
Oh shit. I dropped my controller.
What's up, people? Say hi in the chat, if you're so inclined. So, I actually recently acquired this because I got Sonic Gem Collection for the GameCube because it has some of the lesser known titles. And so I thought it actually had all of the Game Gear titles. Well, apparently it only has the Game Gear titles that aren't on this game. So, Sonic Gems Collection on GameCube does not have Sonic Chaos, so I had to buy this one. But I forgot how awesome this one actually is. These extras are actually pretty good. For instance, if you're a comic fan, which the only comic book I ever got into was the Sonic the Hedgehog comic. So you have, like, kind of an intro information about the comics. You have the entire Sonic the Hedgehog first. I forgot how to actually go page. Oh, here we go. So, yeah, there was a mini-series that Archie actually released before the main series called... I guess it was called Sonic First, but it actually started with at zero, and it was numbered 0 through 3, and that's actually what got me into the Sonic comic, because I saw the very first one, number 0, on the shelf at an HEB in Gatesville, Texas, and I'm like, oh my god, there's a Sonic comic, and so I haven't watched or read the comic in a long, long time. But for most of my childhood, this is what I read. So we have those comic pages, and we actually have the covers of the Sonic the Hedgehog series from number 1 to... yeah, to number 139, plus the Knuckles run of comics, and the Super Specials, and other series, which is the Special Sonic Live. I actually had, I think, part 2 and 3 of the Sonic Quest Death Egg Saga, which was really good, actually. Since I couldn't get a subscription, I actually had a lot of, there's a lot of time where I'd miss issues, so I actually missed the first of the Sonic Quest here, and the main story quests that are issues that led up to these. But I did my best to try and keep up with it. Mecha Madness was one of my favorites. That was freaking awesome. And just the artwork, and you get Sonic roboticized with Knuckles roboticized fighting him, and it's just like ultimate showdown of ultimate destiny. Anyway, let's get some gameplay here. We are gonna play Sonic Chaos. There it is. Sega. So they changed up the 8-bit Sonic sprite a little bit here from the previous games. Tails lagging behind because he doesn't have supersonic speed. Top-notch 8-bit music. So, interesting thing about this is you can actually play as Sonic or Tails. I mean, I don't know why anybody would want to play as Tails, but whatever. Look at me, I'm a streamer who can't speak. So right off the bat, one of the things I actually don't like about a lot of these 8-bit games is the hit detection on the rings is really weird sometimes. Like, I should be able to get two rings at a time when I jump between them, but most of the time I only get one. Also, the edge detection has always bothered me. Like, I should still be able to stand on the ledge. If you look at the 16-bit Sonic games, he's not like that until, like, literally the very end, and you can see his toes hanging over the edge of the platform there. And also, I hope my mic's even getting picked up. I still don't know what the hell is the point of these shoes, these rocket shoes, other than to make me skip most of the level. So you have like long lines of rings like that, but you know, the way you approach them is vertically, you'd think that the detection on them would be a little bit better, so that way you can, so it'd be easier to get a long line of rings instead of just two every time you jump up. Rings are important. Whee! So we had the weird corkscrew things from Sonic 2. I also like how I can jump over the sign and it doesn't count. Most of the older Sonic games, like, even if you try to jump over it, it's almost like the ending tape in Super Mario World. Or even if you try to jump over it, it just ends the level. No contees for me. Is rocket shoes or speed shoes? Speed shoes. Look at this 8-bit speed. Yeehaw. Shit. And you immediately hit a wall. Okay, you can do spin dash in this game. They gotta free me in. Alright, 8-bit speed. Look at that. Yeah. Shit. Well, those rings are gone forever. So like, no matter how many rings you have in this game, when you get hit, you drop four. That shit! Oh! Boing! Is that a rocket shoe? It sure is. And hitting a spring gets rid of your rocket shoes. That's good to know. Whoa! See this. I should be able to get both rings. I shouldn't miss those rings going down this hill. That breaks the flow. I'm trying to get rings, goddammit. I shouldn't have to jump up to get the fucking rings. So things like this wouldn't bother me if the 8-bit games actually came first. But they didn't. Sonic 1 on the Genesis was still the first game. These were made after things were already established in Sonic 1. What? Why did I have to hit that twice? Why is it a flicky bird? Well, okay, I guess it can't be too hard, because the first game was Sonic on a 16-bit system with a completely different programming architecture. Zone 3, or Act 3. Wait, I'm gonna go up here. Where there's spikes. And totally missed the corkscrew. Have I mentioned I'm really good at Sonic games? Just thought I'd point that out. Whoa! Whoa! Not making a very good case for myself here. Alright, so... Oh yeah. I'd have to say the boss battles in these 8-bit Sonic games are actually pretty creative, and I really like them, because actually, so far, none of the 8-bit Sonic games do you actually fight Robotnik in most of the level bosses. It's always either some other robot or some animal-based thing or something. Stretch a little bit. A little bit. Gigopolis. How do you pronounce it? Is it Gigopolis or is it Gigapolis? Is it Gigaopolis? And there's only one A. Wait, I don't know where the spring goes. Whee! Who the fuck is that? Anyway, oh yeah, so another addition is these weird slanted floors, which will throw you off if you go too slow. Oh. Spin dash time! Whee! Yeah, fuck your flooring. Shit. No, I must get to the thing! Okay. Whew. Damn it! That's one thing that always throws me off in these damn games is every ledge he hits way too, he like comes off of way too early. So I'm used to the 16-bit games where, you know, I have that few frames or pixels to jump, but he just kind of scoots off of it. So he just scoots off of it, and I can't jump when he's doing that, so it really throws me off every time. Just the feel of these games just never quite match up to the Genesis. Oh shit. Can I break through that? Oh, I can. Ooh. Oh, where does this go? Nowhere I want to go. Another thing that kind of throws me off is like, you still gain a lot of momentum in the air, like way too much. Like, if I'm standing at a direct standstill and I start moving after the jump, like I should not be going that fast by the time I land. Whoa. Shit. I don't know, maybe it just, I'm just being a curmudgeon and it just takes a little bit of getting used to. So I'm not used to the 8-bit games. I didn't grow up with them, so I didn't play them nearly as much as I did the 16-bit ones. Whee!
It's a bird!
Well, I only got 415 kilometers per hour. It's a good thing Tails wasn't named in Europe. Because then it'd be kilometers per hour. It's too damn hard to pick up rings. Should not be this hard. Whoa. Whoa! Wait, actually, I think it this stuff over here. Yeah, like one of these floors. And some rings. And a ring box that was mostly off screen. Well, that was a poorly timed jump. I just lost all those rings that I gathered. Because, like I mentioned before, I'm an expert Sonic player here. No one else can match my skill. Oh. What's up here? Cool, so I can run on top of that. Holy crap. On Species! Here we go. I'm showing off the 8-bit power. Look how fast I'm going. Oh. So, collecting 100 rings brings you to a bonus stage, apparently. Where you fly around. Holy shit, ginormous rings! Oh. Alright. Giant rings. Get some extra lives. Shit. That's another thing I like about the 16-bit ones, is like, if any part of Sonic's body touches a ring, he grabs it. But in this, like, his ring hitbox is somewhere in his center mass. It's like his legs and the top of his head kind of just pass through rings. Did I just get an emerald? I did! And a whole lot of points. Holy crap. Two Contis!
Two Contis!
And I beat the level. Right? This is Zone 2, right? Is that an extra life? No, it's 10 rings. Okay. Come on. There we go. So apparently gathering 100 rings just ends the level and takes you to a bonus stage. Oh, boss battle. Oh yeah. This guy. Whoa. Well shit, he was easier than the first one. One thing I have noticed is, I don't know if I'm just not finding them, but I haven't seen any shield power-up, and I haven't seen the invincibility. Sleeping Egg Zone. The fuck is a sleeping egg? How can eggs sleep? Excuse me. Excuse me. Alright. So, well, shit. See, right there, I was gonna jump at the very edge of the fucking platform, but he just fucking flies off, and, oh, shit. And I have a spring shoe. I guess I jump off it? Alright. Oh, here we go. Neat. Ah, the air controls just always floaty in these 8-bit games. Come on. Okay. I will say, the camera's much more improved over the first game, and it'll actually just point to wherever you're facing. A little bit of lag, but it's not that bad. By the time you get going fast enough to really need it, it's already there, so it's not that big a deal. Whoa! Okay. Alright, that was a weird robot. Actually, come to think of it, I'm kind of noticing a bug theme in a lot of the enemies in this game. That was lucky. Oh. Well, let's see where this goes. Okay. Like how you still break parts of these blocks, but it doesn't really go anywhere. Just fuck up the... Oh, and die. Okay. Welp. I think it's some of the levels. I don't know if I've hit any yet, but there's boxes like in Sonic, the first Sonic 8-bit game, where that are kind of like a continue box. BRB. I really hope my mic's being picked up. No one's responding. I'd hate to be talking this whole time and not be talking to anyone. That would be tragic. So hitting anything just immediately... Oh, except your head. So I can do this. Whoops. Damn it! It's trying to jump. Okay, it's cool, so I can get my life back. You got your life back! Come on, oh, damn it! Alright. Spin dash! No idea where I'm going. Whee! maybe I can somehow collect. Oh, this moves. Welp, that was short-lived. Maybe I can collect another 100 rings. Let's see if I can find some more rings. I should stop jumping around. As I hit a spring. Whee! Oh. Well, what shenanigans might this bring? Well, wee. No! Spring shoes. Did not protect you against enemies. Oh yeah. No, I just wanted to... I'm gonna jump up here. Oh. So, okay, that whole part is breakable. Oh, end of the level. And it's the bird again. Sonic has passed one. Sleeping Egg Zone. So at least these actually do have a special stage and don't hide the emerald within the levels themselves like the last two Sonic games. Because fucking 8-bit Sonic 2, I couldn't find any of the emeralds. Ah! I know where of some of them... Oh, damn it. I know where some of them are in the first one I was able to find, but I couldn't find any of them. Oh. Shit. Oh. Well, I actually made it up there. Oh, come on. All right. Okay, I need to quit messing around. This is a Sonic game, I'm on a timer. Okay. Is this another design flaw? How the fuck are you supposed to know which blocks are breakable? Oh, 100 rings! Oh, this is new. Is each special stage different? Shit. Oh, I'm being timed. Holy crap. God damn it. Alright. Okay, I can do this. Man, this really tests your, like, jumping and abilities. Fuck. Oh. God damn it. Okay. I got 10 seconds. I have no idea where I'm supposed to be going. Shit. I'm not gonna make it. I'm streaming! Hi!
I couldn't tell with all your...
I got 2 emeralds! Emeralds! Did you take my emeralds? What are you doing? Debating on what? Oh, does it matter? Does it matter?
Does it?
I don't know. Probably not. This level had a lot of padding getting up to the bad guy here. Oh, right. I did find out that he will squish you. Shit. Chill with the fucking machine gun, dude. Yeah. Yeah. Bitch. Stay on top of your head. I got 3 Conti apostrophes. 4 Conti apostrophes. Guess that means I'm doing good? Mecha Green Hill Zone. So, I did play this sometime last weekend when I first got this collection, and I actually couldn't get to the boss in it. Oh, those just hurt you. Okay. No, whoa, okay. Oh, that doesn't kill him. I just hit the spring. Alright. Oh, yeah. So, yeah, those floors just kind of drop you if you're not going fast enough. Oh, so do those floors. Alright. Yeah. Extra man's... No. I'm gonna go up. Excuse me. Oh, come on. Whatever. Oh, that's probably not good. Black goopy stuff? Probably not good. Whee! So we got rings just outside of reach, and you have to jump for them. Those look like the rocket shoes. It is the rocket shoes. I could have swore that, like, I could hit a button. Oh, fuck. Well, at least I didn't lose rings. Oh. Anyway, I could have swore there was a button I could hit that would make me do like a little flip when I had the rocket shoes. Rocket boots! Yeah! So, come to think of it, yeah, the hitbox on the rain thing still bothers me because rings are especially important in this game, because the only way to get to the special stage, apparently, is by getting 100 of them. So, why make it harder to collect the damn rings? Well, I guess maybe I answered my own question for introducing fake difficulty or something, just by making something that should be easy, more difficult than it should be. See, look, I can't... If this was fucking 16-bit, I'd be getting those rings. Alright, rocket shoes. Rocket shoes into that... Whoa, okay. I can. And it doesn't... go anywhere. Oh. Whee. Ah, I doubt I'm gonna get 100 rings on this anyways. Oh! Is that the invincibility? Shit! Must get! Alright, rah! Well, invincibility confirmed. Whee! And the invincibility runs out by the time I hit another enemy. And I died. So I can't really hear the music since I have it kind of turned down so it doesn't bleed into the mic. Whee! Alright. Go through this wall. Kill this guy for no reason. Break some shit. Play on some springs. Whee! Spikes already. One thing I do like about Sonic games is... Ah, well, not fucking up. Anyway, you can bump against the side of spikes and not get hurt, because, you know, the side isn't pointy, so there's no reason why they would hurt you. Only the pointy side hurts. Alright, let's go a little faster this time. Not get hit the spring. Fucking hell. Oh no! Well, the difficulty level does seem to spike a little by the time you get here. And maybe I should see where that other little platform goes next time, because I'm sure I'll die again. Whee! Alright, that's the way it's done. This is how we do it. Grab some rings. Jump. Oh, I just bounce on spikes like that. Okay. Damn it! It's like the instant where I'm used to jumping is when he slips off the corner of a fucking ledge and I keep missing jumps that way. Alright, where does this go? To some rings. Is that it? Well. That's it for now. A lot of music changing in this. Invincibility has music, the rocket shoes have music. Shit. Oh, whoops. Alright, get some speed. Oh, shit. God damn it. I did it again. Well, that's convenient. So this is teaching you a valuable skill because you'll have to do this in the third act too. Damn it! All right, so now I gotta be careful. That was close. All right, so now I gotta... fucking hell. All right, I jumped, and I jumped. Didn't realize that thing moved. You know, it'd be nice to know how many lives I have left. That would be... Oh, I have 8. How do you get so many lives? Oh, shit. Oh, well, fuck it. Okay, springs don't work on rocket boot Sonic, apparently. Hope you guys like this music. Whoops, woo. See, it's weird because jumping makes going up slopes a lot easier because of the weird extra momentum you get from freaking jumping. Man, there's a lot of slowdown in this too. Alright. Oh. God damn it! So that's another thing that makes these fucking Game Gear Sonic games hard, is the screen's so fucking small. You have to have superhuman reaction speeds to avoid a lot of this shit, because... you just don't have time going as fast as he does. You don't have time to process the visual information in order to react. Plus the whole thing where, you know, you can't jump off of the very edge of a... Edge of an edge, yes. I know what I'm talking about. See, I hit the jump button just now, and nothing happened. I have to train myself to jump like way early. Alright, kill him, jump, bounce. Kill him and slow the fuck down. Alright. There we go. Wee. That's a lot of rings. Sure wish the hit detection didn't fucking suck.
I did it! I got a Boyd!
Sonic has passed 2. Do I only get 4 Conti apostrophes? No more than 4. Alright, I seem to think like... Oh well. Just the thing, like, shit, see, you can't go too damn fast. Because that happens. We were trying to hit the jump button. Alright. One of these, and you don't want to stop because that happens. This is why it's hard, folks. This level's fucking hard. Alright. So you don't want to go too fast here, but you have to maintain speed on that other part. I mean, a lot of it just comes down to memorization. You just have to know what's coming up. This is a game that's impossible to do a blind run on. So you want that, because it's rings. There's not enough bounce to make it to the other side, and there's not enough momentum to stay on the slope. So I have a window on my other screen, so I can kind of preview the stream, or see, you know, make sure the video is still going right. And I get to relive every death, because there's a good like 15 second delay between each. Ooh! Alright. So jump way the fuck over here. Alright. So now, you run over here, jump here, and now I can kind of take my time. Oh! Boss battle! Alright. Oh yeah. And I get squished. Alright. Oh man. There's a fucking... How would they put a tree so far off the screen that you can just barely see the branches there? Unless that... Well, maybe that's a leftover from the Sega, the Master System version, which almost always have, you know, much better viewing angle. Stay here. Okay. Alright, so I do remember actually fighting this boss. You don't want to fucking... You don't want to get... God damn it! I want the ring, but I don't want to get squished! Shit's hard, man. Shit's hard, man. Hmm, is it me or does the jump sound seem like it's off? Like it doesn't do the jump sound until like a good full second after I actually hit the jump button. Okay. Alright. Make sure I got the speed, jump. Do not run into him. Alright. So I can't, oh yeah, I have to jump on his head. And it is that. Okay. Alright, I got the rhythm down. I got the rhythm and the rhyme. Oh, did that hit him? Shit. Quick, fuck! Come on! Yeah, continue. Alright. And just like in most Sonic games, you kind of want to stay on the high path if at all possible. And that's exactly why I slowed down. So I guess for curiosity's sake, I'll see where the lower path takes me over here. Kind of take my time. Okay, it goes through here. Okay, I can jump on that. It takes me to one of these things. Okay. Son of a beach. already got this. Shit. See, you can't judge that jump because you can't see what's fucking coming. And I've already used another continue. Sucks, you only get 3 lives per continue. Yes, come watch me fail, it's Sonic Chaos. An old 8-bit Sonic game that I never grew up with, so I haven't played much. This is only my second time actually playing it. Alright, let's just keep doing this. This works. Jump over here. Land on that. Alright. Come on. Alright. Son of a bitch. So, he doesn't drop like that unless I'm right under him. I wonder if he's, like, reading me being on this side of the screen. Like, as a weird wraparound, like, he's detecting me under him like that. That's an interesting exploit. Haha, gotcha! Still got 2 Conti apostrophes. Aqua Planet Zone! Am I on another fucking planet? I actually don't think... I haven't actually played this level. Oh, I can break that. Alright. Oh, water. Fun. Water in Sonic games always fills my heart with pleasure. Oh, invisibility. Sweet. Haha, skipped all that water. Fuck off with your water. Ooh, rocket shoes. I don't know where I'm going. I guess like any other Sonic game, just go right. That's how you win. Oh. Oh, it's the spear thingies. Okay. Let's see if I can get on that. I'm glad that gave me enough time to react and, you know, jump off it before it fucking crumbled. Give me another Conti! Oh. Another thing I've learned about these games is always head left first, because sometimes they like to hide things like right behind you, just off screen. So if you head right, you'd never see it. There's little penguins! I have no rings. Whoa, here's a bunch of rings. Well then. Spear Dash! Yeah! Damn it. Sweet! Special stage! Which I think... Oh, okay. Okay. Am I supposed to do something else here? Or just keep going through these pipes? Can I change direction? No. There's... Okay, so this one... Oh, I bet... Shit. How am I supposed to know what to do? What's going on? Well, yeah, I think I'm fucked. How do I change directions? Well, just put me down back here. Alright. Why do I keep getting invincibilities? That one was weird. No emerald for me. I didn't get the emerald. Well, I didn't get the emerald in that last special stage. Because that was a really weird special stage. Oh, go left first. Nothing over here. Alright. Whee! Whoop, hang on. Whoa. No. Alright. Wait, I want to go up here. How do I get up there? Oh. Probably could use that invincibility for the boss here. Oh, it's a penguin army. Yeah. Whoa, okay. Okay. Alright, so how do I get up? Oh, I guess I just gotta jump from here. Here, okay, alright. I got an idea. Spin dash jump! Nope, that didn't work. Shit. How the fuck are you supposed to get up there? No, where'd it go back this way? Ah, fuck it. Alright, bonk, 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 bonk. Whoa, they changed directions! What the fuck? Snuff a bitch. Seriously, how the fuck are you supposed to get up there? Alright, fuck it, let's just go. Let's see if this actually lasts. No. What's the point of that? It ends before the boss even shows up. Okay, so he comes in the middle. Oh, and he bounces. Alright, well. That would have been good information. Jazz, this game's hard. I don't know how to get that ring box up there. Love you, Jazz. Come on. Alright. Stop changing directions. Stop it. God damn it. Oh, boy. Continue. Yes. I will play until I'm out of continues. I think I have two left. Hang on a sec. I'm going to pause. Alright. Game on. Wait. Hang on. Oh, shit. Come on. Dude, stop! Alright. God damn it! The fucking springs? Like, I don't even have to touch to activate, but the fucking rings? Have weird-ass hitboxes? Oh, well. That was all for naught. Thought I saw something there, but there wasn't. Chase is standing right behind me. Chase, this game's hard. All right, this guy's going to come down, jump, fire thing. I wasn't touching it. It didn't touch me. Well. Okay, Penguin Army. Do your worst. Alright. Oh, came back. Okay. Okay. Does he always jump to the left? He does. Ooh, can I stay on top? Holy shit, how many... I did it! Wow, he... Oh, that... Oh, come on! So, since he took, like, fucking 20 hits, and he has a second form that fires rockets at you, I'm guessing this is gonna be the last boss. But I got this. Alright, gotta defeat this little penguin army that comes in. This one takes 2 hits. Unless you hit him from the side, or from underneath. Of course, I'm doing this without any fucking rings. Alright, alright. Shit. I'm gonna stay above him. God damn it! I think this is my last continue. Alright, I got this. I believe in me. Don't believe in yourself, believe in the me that believes in me. Whoa! Okay. Looks like I hit him at a weird angle. God damn it, this is fucking nerve-wracking. I keep hitting him from the side right before I land. Alright. Bounce to the right. Oh, okay. It's fun trying to keep up with where Sonic is on top of the screen! So, interestingly... He doesn't seem to fire unless I am below his line of sight. Alright, do they home in on me? No. Oh, come on. So the hitbox on rings is super small, but the hitbox on enemies is big as fucking shit where you don't even have to be fucking touching it for it to kill you. Stop changing directions! Okay. Okay. Whoa! Should probably count how many times I need to hit him. Okay, that was 10 after I started counting halfway through, so I think the figure of 20 hits is probably accurate. I got this. Fucking useless invincibility. I don't know how to get the fucking ring box up there. That would make things a hell of a lot easier. Ooh, that's close. One, two, three, four, five. Fuck! I'm gonna get squished! Oh no. This game is fucking hard. Welp. I did say it was gonna be a short stream. I think that's a good spot to end it. We'll end it on the cutscene again. We'll bookend it on the opening here. The tail's being all slow. Yeah, alright. Thanks for watching. For those of you that stopped by, I'm trying to do this more often, like every other day or so, or maybe every day for like an hour or so, you know. I don't know how long it's gonna be, but anyway, peace.